for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Helene Curtis, makers of Stop At, Suave, and Shampoo Plus Egg. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers from coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
It's a great privilege to have as our guest panelist this evening an actor who has distinguished himself on the stage, in the movies, and on television, Mr. Melvin Douglas.
And now may I introduce you that charming lady with probably the most contagious laughter in, on the airwaves, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now our distinguished publisher panelist, who has been dazzling audiences upstate in Jamestown and Buffalo, has come home to roost. Mr. Bennett Cerf.
It's nice to be roosting again. Well, ladies and gentlemen, in the past week, most of the newspapers in New York have doubled their price. But I'm glad to say there's one daily that still comes in the giant economy size. And that's John Charles Day.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. Once again tonight, we have as our mission to puzzle the panel so completely that everybody's happy except the panel. We might be able to do it, too. We have some interesting guests tonight. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the program. We'll meet our first challenger in just 1 minute.
I wish my hair were more attractive. I wish it weren't so dry, dull, hard to manage.
That's suave, you suave, condition with suave, your hair will be lovely with suave.
Yes, just a touch of suave hairdressing instantly corrects dryness and all the natural sparkling highlights spring to life. Suave makes your hair so soft, easy to comb and arrange. Never any oily look or feel, because only Helene Curtis Suave contains amazing greaseless lanolin. Remember, a touch of suave is worth a million wishes. Try light, fragrant Helene Curtis Suave lotion or the new special Suave cream for extra dry hair.
And now let's meet our first contestant. Will you come in and sign in, please? Right there. Irene Gora, is that right? Is it Miss or Mrs.?
Mrs.
Mrs. Gora, Mrs. Gora, the panel. Fine, upstanding group. Let's see if we can't rough them up a little bit. Will you come over here and sit down with me? You know how we keep score?
Yes, I do.
Fine, then let's let everybody at home and our friends here in the theater, minus my friends on the panel, know exactly what your line is. Panel, Mrs. Gora is salaried, and let's begin the general festivities with Bennett Cerf.
John, I noticed that you didn't tell us where Mrs. Gora hailed from. Was that a deliberate omission, or did you just forget?
It was just an attempt to confuse and confound. If you'd like to know where Mrs. Gora comes from, where do you come from, Mrs. Gora?
Hollis, Queens.
Hollis, Queens? Hollis, Queens.
Not very helpful. Mrs. Gora, is there a product concern with what you do?
Yes, there is.
Would you describe it as a useful product?
Very useful.
Well, you look like a live outdoorsy sort of girl. Would this be a product that you could use outdoors?
Yes.
Has it got any moving parts?
Yes.
I don't know what's funny about this. Is it a product that you might have to have some kind of a license to operate?
No.
No, that's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, if it has moving parts, does it also move?
Yes.
Could it move without being plugged into something?
No, just so that we don't get lost here, it has certainly, in its normal functioning, every capacity to change its locale from one time to another. But this is not to indicate necessarily anything that would lead you to ask any questions that I'd have to give you a no answer to.
I wish you'd really finished that sentence. Well, Bennett established that it had moving parts. Are these parts other than metal? No.
That makes it two down and eight to go, Mr. Douglas.
Well, with all these moving parts, is it possible that this product is alive in some way?
No.
No. Three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
You said it's used outdoors. Could it ever be used indoors?
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. Could you hold it in your hand?
Oh, yes.
Would you carry it around with you?
Well, you could.
You might, yeah.
Might.
Does it do anything to anything else?
Yes.
Does it improve something else by its use?
Yes.
Is it ever worn?
Yes.
Is it worn by women?
Yes.
Is it in any way in the jewelry department?
No.
No. Four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mrs. Gora, is this product also worn by men?
Yes, it is.
When it's worn, is it clearly visible to the naked eye of a passerby?
No.
Well,
not
let me
always.
Say here, not always.
Not always.
But it can be.
Oh, it can be
yeah.
visible? Mm-hmm. Is it worn above the waist?
It could be.
It could also be worn below the waist?
Yes, it could.
You wouldn't have to be eccentric to...
No.
is it worn above the ankles?
Yes. Could be.
Oh, could also be worn below the ankles?
Yep.
Yes, it could be.
In other words, this product could cover a person pretty much from head to foot.
Just about.
At least I would say this, that it could be worn and be useful from, realistically, head to foot.
And it has moving parts, and you don't need a license to operate. Does a person ever sit down or lie flat in this product?
Yes.
Golly, I hate to think what I'm... lie very flat in it?
Oh, yes. Don't you think so?
Would it be some kind of a chair?
No.
No, that's five down and five to go. Miss Kilgallen.
You say it's worn, Mrs. Gora?
Yes,
actually
it is.
Worn?
Yes.
You would not consider an electric blanket wearing apparel.
No.
And it's metal?
Yes.
Yeah.
And you can hold it in your hand.
Be no call for a conference, please.
Has this been worn, or has this sort of thing been worn in a century before this?
No.
Six down and four to go, Mr. Douglas.
Miss Gora, is it you wouldn't by any chance be one of those who have seen men from Mars arriving, would you?
No.
And this is in the nature of clothing, is it?
Yes.
Well, it's in the nature of clothing if we accept that connotation in its broadest possible sense.
How broad can clothing be, Mr. Dale?
Depends on the shape you're in.
Well, we have haven't an answer yet. What shape is
no,
the wearer of this?
Actually, Milman, what I'm trying to say is that you would have to consider the category of clothing very broadly if you wish to include what we're talking about as a matter of clothing.
Oh, did you, Arlene?
I've got something going.
Well, I'll pass to Miss Francis for the moment.
All right, Miss Arlene?
Is it made of chains?
Of what?
Are there links in it?
Links? You mean L-I-N-X? No, no links. Wait a minute. I got to call the expert in on this.
Is that what you're thinking of? No.
Coat of mail?
No, but it could be a chain.
We have looked this over, you know, very... We want to be... You know,
fair.
We do, you know, and
I
so
understand.
We'll be fair. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Gore, I confess I'm completely baffled. I'm just going to ask you a question, really at random. Do you wear this... could this be worn at all times of the year?
Yep.
Yes.
Both indoors and outdoors?
Both indoors and outdoors.
Is it, does it do anything to improve the health of the wearer?
Specifically as an issue of health, it has been used, I dare say, many, many times where the specific application was meant as an end result to achieve a betterment in the condition of health of the victim who it was applied.
Excuse me, I'm being whispered.
I don't know. May we have one moment?
You may have 10 seconds
do you want
for a conference.
Moment?
Sure.
We were thinking
maybe
of the
rings.
Maybe it has bells in it or something.
What?
No, Arlene has a strange notion that it has bells in it, but I'm stuck with this. Has it got bells in it?
No bells. 8 down and 2 to go. Miss Kilgallen, who looks like she's had an idea.
Well, could be a terrible one, too. Could this be part of clothing rather than an article of clothing in itself?
Yes.
Is it possible that I have one of these in my dress?
Possible.
Mm-hmm. It's possible.
Is it something that goes up and down?
Yes.
Most of the time, yes.
Is
although I've seen it go sideways.
Is it a slide fastener, colloquially known as zipper?
Yes, that is the product. Very good, very good. And now, Dorothy, I want to congratulate you, and perhaps you will tell us now what Mrs. Gora has to do with zippers.
She repairs them.
She prepares them.
Repairs them.
Repairs
no.
them. That makes it 9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Douglas.
She manufactures them.
She doesn't manufacture them. That
she
makes it 10 down and 0. Test them is right. 11 down and 0 more to go. And actually, just to clarify very quickly the issue, Mrs. Gora is with Coates and Clark, manufacturers of them, and they bring her the new zippers, and she tests them out in all their possible applications for heavy uniforms and things like that to make sure they
I'm
work.
I'm glad out. She doesn't have to test them after they're being worn.
Yes, I think that's nice too. Thank you very much, Mrs. Gora. Nice to have you with us. Structure panel. Let's see if we can do it again. Will our next challenger come in and sign in, please? Tom? Tom Eagleton, is that right? Where are you from, Mr. Eagleton?
St. Louis, Missouri.
St. Louis, Missouri, the panel. Sir,
good evening.
You come with me? Are you familiar with our scorekeeping methods?
Yes, sir, I am.
All right, then. Let's let everybody at home and those here with us know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, Mr. Eagleton is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization, Mr. Eagleton?
No, I do not.
That's 1 down and 9 to go, Mr. Douglas.
Are these services that you perform? You do perform services?
Yes, sir, that's right.
Are these services that you perform something that you do to someone?
In a way, sir, yes.
This, however, could be misleading. I think we'd have to agree that in instances there could be the application of do to someone, but this doesn't necessarily describe the whole area of service.
That's very enlightening. Are they services that could be performed for one of us on the panel here?
Yes, that's right.
Very likely, as a matter of fact.
That sounds as if, in your mind, they might have something to do with education, perhaps?
No, not at all. That's too down the date to go, Miss Francis.
Not that we don't need some education, Mel, you understand. Do you work for any branch of a government?
Yes, ma'am.
Would it be the federal government?
No, ma'am.
That makes it 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Eagleton, would it be the local St. Louis government?
Yes, sir, that's right.
The municipal government?
Yes.
And you could do something for people on this panel?
Yes, sir.
If we went to St. Louis?
That's right. Free question.
Would it be a pleasant sort of a service? Would we enjoy this service?
I think not. No.
Well, wait a minute. I got to have a small talk. We want to be fair, Bennett. We were a little hasty, perhaps, in saying that it couldn't be pleasant. Under certain circumstances, you might find it most pleasant. Under other circumstances, you might find it quite unpleasant.
Well, Mr. Eagleton, have you any connection with the punitive department, the police department of St. Louis?
No, sir.
No. That's 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Have we discovered whether Mr. Eagleton is state or
yes.
Local?
Yes, municipal.
Yes, it has been asked in there. He has a clear and definite affiliation with municipal government in St. Louis.
I see. Not punitive. Are you a member of the executive branch of
no, ma'am.
Municipal government?
That makes it 5 down and 5 to go, Mr. Douglas.
Is this service, does this service have something to do, anything to do with the maintenance of the health of the community?
No, sir.
That makes it 6 down and 4 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you do investigating in any way?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you? And you could help somebody on the panel?
Possibly.
Do you investigate income?
Possibly.
You could.
You could investigate income.
Mm-hmm.
Do you investigate family relations?
Possibly, could. Yes.
Could.
Do you have anything to do with the census?
No, ma'am.
No. That makes it 7 down and 3 to go, Mr. Service.
I thought, too. Mr. Eagleton, is the city enriched in any way by your services, in the collection of taxes or license fees or anything of that sort?
No, sir.
No. That makes it 8 down and 2 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, if you investigate, are you primarily an investigator?
No.
No. That makes it 9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Douglas. We're having a grand night.
Does what you do have anything to do with the well-ordered running of the city? Does the city,
Yes, sir, that's right. I hope so.
Would it be in connection with something in the way of utilities?
No, that makes it 10 down and no more to go. And I want you to meet the circuit attorney or district attorney for St. Louis, Mr. Eagleton, age 27, elected to office.
John, I have an objection.
Bennett, before you say a word, before you say a word, Bennett, I want you to be on notice. I have my lawyer with me. Now, go ahead.
I distinctly asked you if Mr. Eagleton had something to do with the punitive department.
No, but then you specified police. If you had left it with punitive department, you were in gravy. But you said punitive department, the police department, and we had to say no.
And I don't know how Mr. Eagleton could have said for a minute that people would not enjoy his services, whatever they are. Just meeting him has been a pleasure, Mr. Eagleton.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Dorothy.
John, if it's not the executive branch of the municipal government, what is it? Just so I'll know the next time.
He's elected. He's elected to office and
but to what branch?
You're not under the mayor's office.
No, the mayor is the chief executective official. And he's law enforcement.
No, I didn't mean was he an executive.
This is a peculiar circumstance. Actually, he is not subject to the mayoralty authority there. St. Louis is not a county of itself, but it has that general character. He also, and nobody asked the question, he reports to the state and does work for the state, you see, in the legal. He's not a part of the executive.
Is he legislative branch?
No, actually, it's the state government. He would be probably applied to the executive government and the state government, but not in the municipal government. Nobody asked the state question, and he's not. Well, goodbye. It's nice to see you. And we'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first,
Why wasn't I a district attorney? Well, I know now. And first, here's Dorothy Jarnack dancing a message from...
Cream deodorant, anyone? Don't be afraid. No need to plunk your pinkies in a gooey cream jar. Stop It presents a whole new idea in cream deodorants and antiperspirants. A flowing cream your fingers never touch. It's the new Stop It flowing cream deodorant. Twist, and from the rounded applicator top, outflows exactly the right amount. So you stroke on an effective film of protection. This is the only cream that dries twice as fast. Now you can stop walking a tightrope with ordinary deodorants, because here's the perfect balance of an effective deodorant and antiperspirant. You get this double protection wherever you see the name Stop It. In the new Stop It flowing cream, new Misty Fine Stop It spray, new Stop It stick. Which one for you?
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery guest, for which I have to ask my friends on the panel to blindfold themselves. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? As you know, in the case of our mystery guest, we go to a different form of questioning. You ask one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin it all with Arlene Francis.
Well, a great deal of the sound waves were masculine from the audience. Would I be correct in assuming that this is a dazzling female?
I think you would be fair in assuming that, yes.
She's taken her toll of you, all right.
Sir?
I would like the mystery guest to answer this question herself, please, not you, John. Would you be called one of those dazzling dishes from Hollywood?
Yeah, honey.
Now, Bennett, you want to ask me a question, Bennett? No, I guess you don't. Miss Kilgallen?
Are you primarily an actress from the Flickers, who has not appeared very much on the stage?
Primarily. True. Thank you.
Mr. Douglas.
Are you under 50?
Yeah.
Miss Francis.
Are you a leading woman?
Sometimes.
Oh, boy, is she. What?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Mr. Seth.
Does that mean that sometimes you are not the star of the picture in which you appear?
Yeah.
Not fair.
Really?
I won't count that as a question, Betty, because I take that as a point of information and clarification.
Oh, really? are you a blonde? Now.
A true blonde.
Miss Kilgallen?
A true blonde?
Yeah.
This makes it hard. Were you born somewhere other than the United States? No.
That's one down and nine to go. Mr. Douglas?
Are you married to someone whom we might know very well?
Yeah.
Miss Francis?
Gosh. A true blonde. That makes... And somebody will know. Somebody just made a noise like a cat. I didn't mean it that way. I'm not a true blonde either. But it's just... Are you appearing in a picture right now on Broadway?
No.
No, that's too darn a date to go, Mr. Seth.
Do you gallop 28 miles to appear before any camera that happens to be turned in your general direction?
I don't gallop.
I didn't hear the answer.
No, that's a difficult question, Bennett, specifically to answer.
Well, I had in mind, did
if
you...
If one is there, I won't...
She's not
turn
married.
Turn my back.
Oh, she's not. Well, I was thinking of Jane Mansfield, and I'm wrong. I pass.
Yes.
All right, Miss Kilgallen.
Oh, I'm absolutely lost. Are you more a comedian than a straight dramatic actress?
I'm very versatile. I do both.
Oh,
Mr. Douglas?
Is your husband in the entertainment field also?
No, he's home now.
But he is in the entertainment field also when he's not home. Miss Preston.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
I'm lost. Are you extremely shapely? I hope you consider
I'll
that a compliment.
I'll answer that question briefly, if I may. Yes. Sir?
Going by a process of elimination, do you happen to have a last name that has been famous on another television program recently?
Yeah.
But no relation of the literary Van Dorens.
No.
But Mamie.
Mamie, that's right. Well, I must say, you had them on the ropes there for a good deal
of
time.
Yes, I did.
I think Bennett put it very well. By a process of elimination, I knew that sooner or later they'd have to go. True blonde. See that? Isn't that lovely hair?
Well, I touch it up a little bit.
Are
you making a picture now? Here? Oh, yes. I was going to ask you if anybody was going to ask me what I was in town for.
Well, we'll ask you. What are you in town for,
well,
Miss Van Doren?
Well, my picture, Untamed Youth, will be at the Paramount Theater here come Easter week.
Come Easter week? Fine.
Untamed Youth.
And I might say, and I think
untamed,
you have... Untamed Youth.
Untamed. You?
That's what I thought. Are you the Untamed Youth, Miss Van Doren?
A little bit, I think.
A little bit, yes.
Who is the Untamed Youth in the picture?
Well, there are a bunch of us.
And I must say that we all, I think, you will find stand in the ranks of admirers of your good husband, Ray Anthony, who turns out some of the loveliest music that is heard in these United States. Thanks very much for being our guest. Will you say good night to the panel, please?
New sunshine, yellow, shampoo plus egg puts sunny sparkle in your hair. Use shampoo plus egg, Helling Curtis, shampoo plus egg.
Yes, nothing shampoos a sunny sparkle into your hair like shampoo plus egg, the sunshine yellow shampoo that conditions your hair. Only shampoo plus egg can leave your hair so soft, silky, yet so manageable. Can give it such life, luster, sunny sparkle. Your hair responds to shampoo plus egg. So easy and pleasant to use, it's just like washing your hair with sunshine. So put sunny sparkle in your hair.
Use Helling Curtis shampoo plus egg.
Costs no more than ordinary shampoo.
And thus, I would like, until next week, to say this is John Daly saying good night.
Good night,
John.
Good
night, Miss Dorothy.
Good night, Jill. Good night, Melvin.
Good night. Good night, Arlene.
Nice to have you here, Mel. Good night, Untamed Youth. That goes for you, too. Good night, Bennett.
For a moment, I thought we had that judo girl back. Good night, John.
Good night, Miss Nugget of 1957. It's nice to know you, too. Nice to have you with us, Melvin. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line?
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on. Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.